For years, drill music has featured stammering drums and smooth 808s. Whether it's Chicago, London, or even Brooklyn style, they all tend to share the same characteristics, but now there's a new drill sound that's shaking it all up. This new genre is sometimes called sample drill, and it's rising up from a totally different New York City borough, the Bronx. Over the last several months, there have been numerous examples, including B Lovee's If You Know You Know, K Flock's Being Honest, and DThang's Talk Facts. But just who came up with this style in the first place? And why is the answer to that question DThang? I mean, at least according to him, that is. If you want to find out the truth, then keep watching our newest episode of Before They Were Famous that explores the career of one of today's hottest artists. DThang was born on September 19th, 2002 in the New York City neighborhood of the Bronx. He grew up in the River Park Towers complex, which features four buildings, two with 38 stories and two with 44 stories. In fact, by the time these buildings were completed in 1975, they were officially the tallest buildings in the entire borough.
Where did you grow up in New York?
The Bronx.
The Bronx?
Yeah.
So what's the best spots to eat in the Bronx? You know, you gotta recommend people.
We don't really eat in the Bronx, feel me? If I want to go get some Spanish food or something, go to the I Block. Not really, feel me? I go to Harlem, eat, feel me? Shit like that. Well, I don't really eat in the Bronx.
Alright.
Unless it's McDonald's or something.
DThang grew up in proximity to a few other young men that would go on to become equally big names in the genre of Bronx drill. I'm talking about the likes of Dougie B, B Lovee, and K Flock.
Ain't related to me.
Like, I did this, Sonny. Can't wait to see Auntie now. Huh. Just gonna learn today, I ain't gonna lie. Stop playing with me, bro. Gangsta, bro. Stop playing with me in they raps, bro. For real.
Now, if you want this inside track on the kind of hustling activities that DThang would get up to with his River Park crew, well, I don't have the details on that stuff for you. My man knows better than to speak openly about all that. But needless to say, much like his contemporaries and friends, DThang established a name for himself in the Bronx as a mover and shaker long before he ever considered becoming a musician.
They don't really know. Like, I don't really want to, like, film me. It's all PT, you heard? Heard Richmond Plaza thugs. They don't know. They don't know. Chill. They don't know. I ain't gonna lie.
Actually, if I'm being totally honest, I don't really think DThang ever considered music as a viable career choice until late last year. Why do I think that? Well, because he basically said so himself.
Real quick, let me know where you from. You know what I'm saying? How we first got started in this music stuff.
Like, what you mean?
Like, right. How we first got started in the music. You know what I'm saying? Like,
me personally?
Yeah, you. Were you here with me?
Yeah. When I was like... Like a year ago, like when I really wanted to do music, it was like a year ago when I first dropped like Caution.
Prior to stepping foot into a recording booth for the first time in the summer of 2020 and knocking a home run right out of the park with Caution, DThang claims that he never messed with the music game before. Not only that, but according to him, he wasn't even a fan of music in the first place, having not listened to much of it even as a kid. You know those people that just never listened to music? Yeah, he became a musician. Funny how that works.
Who do you feel like were your biggest inspirations when it came to like starting the music stuff? Like, who were you listening to kind of coming up and kind of drawing the inspirations from before you started making music?
I wasn't really into music. Mm. I wasn't into music that much. I used to listen to my older. I didn't really know about a lot. Like, I didn't know about a lot of people. I didn't know about a lot of, like,
I mean, heck, he didn't even know that his name DThang, a nickname given to him by a buddy, was inspired by a Chicago drill artist by the same name, the brother of Lil Durk, and a man who would sadly lose his life just this past year.
My son, he gave me the name. He fake was naming all of us, but I ain't know like he was naming us over like the Chicago, like that. I ain't know that. After I told him, like years after I got my name in Shamlin, so I'm like, what the f***? Why you gave me that name? He was like, cuz, Chicago, and we're the gang. I was like, oh, you got me dead. Yeah, that's what he said, but he gave it to me and shit.
But once Caution dropped, the fan response totally overwhelmed DThang, and he quickly realized that he had to move different and start leveling up if he really wanted to turn this into a viable career choice. So here's the thing about, well, DThang. He might be grouped into the rest of the Bronx drill scene, but as far as he's concerned, he's not only different, he started the whole damn movement himself. Well, maybe not by himself.
You started Bronx drill.
I started it. I can't say I started it. Fremont, all my friends, they locked up right now. Fremont Hearts, we started this. When we started, that's when everybody, the whole Bronx, I'm the reason the whole Bronx lit right now. Mm. Gangsta.
We stamped that.
For sure.
Alongside some friends from River Park, like fellow rapper Bando, as well as a few others who DThang says are all locked up right now, this young man claims to have invented the sound and technique that would eventually become a mainstay in Bronx drill. Is he right? Well, to be honest, the validity of that statement is hard to accurately determine. Bronx drill sound began with the rapper Ron Suno, who started crafting drill beats back in 2013 when he was only 13 years old. It would take a number of years for his style to catch on and gain an online audience. In 2019, he had dropped the hit song Pinocchio and put his new genre on the map for the very first time. That's a good year or so before other artists like B Lovee, K-Flock, and yes, even DThang would begin releasing music. By DThang's own admission, Caution was his very first track, and that song didn't see release until the summer of 2020, or about 10 months after Suno's single. Whether or not DThang is the true originator of the Bronx drill sound, it's hard to argue that he hasn't mastered it. After releasing Caution, he followed it up with tracks like Drama and GZ Bop, the latter of which would go on to become his biggest solo single to date, with over 1.3 million views on YouTube alone. What's his secret to success? Well, one thing that sets DThang apart from the rest in his field is how he's brought his entire crew along the way for every step of his journey.
Who I came with, like, he gonna be making my beats. Like, every song that I did on this album, he made that beat.
Right.
Every, like, stuff like that. Like, that's what I'm trying to have. Like, person that was with me came from the bottom. He made every beat on my album.
That's a great friend with some real talent who definitely knows how to delegate. With the advice and support from some of these same friends, DThang is beginning to mess around with genres outside of drill music. But for the most part, he plans on sticking with what's working. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. I don't blame him. Still, my man is always tinkering with his skills and abilities, getting ready to unleash different styles upon his listening audience should the demand for him to do so increase.
Have you begun working on anything outside of drill? Have you been kind of experimenting with your sound?
Yeah. Yes. People in my circle, they love when it, I don't be like when I do it, but people in my circle, they love when I do it. They always tell me, just keep doing that, bro. Just keep getting that bag. Keep getting that bag. So make you different from everybody else. So make you different, bro. You could do all that. Just be doing it sometimes. Make them happy.
With it being so early in DThang's career, he's only just now, and I literally mean just days ago, dropped his first long form project. Get Back Gang was released on Apple Music on October 25th and features a number of tracks including his hit single, Habits. In terms of next steps, DThang plans on moving on to a full-blown mixtape followed by the inevitable debut studio album. As of this moment, he's still independent, but he's willing to sign a contract with a label if the right deal comes around. But even if that doesn't happen, he's more than confident that he'd continue making it on his own. As for the rest of the story, well, that'll unfold in due time. After all, this is Before They Were Famous. My name is Clyde, and if you enjoyed this video, please take a moment to like and subscribe. And if there's another artist out there that you'd like to see profiled on our channel, please leave their name down below, and I'll see you guys in another video.